Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about resistance, that is antimicrobial resistance. Okay, so antimicrobial resistance refers to development of resistance to any antimicrobial agent by an microorganism, and this antimicrobial resistance is of two type. Okay, that is acquired antimicrobial resistance and intrinsic antimicrobial resistance. So that resistance may be acquired or intrinsic. First we will discuss about acquired. So this refers to emergence of resistance in bacteria that are ordinarily susceptible to antimicrobial agent by acquiring the genes coding for resistance. Suppose this is a bacteria number A. Okay, we are administering any antibiotic. Okay, antibiotic is given to this bacteria. This bacteria normally dies, but after acquiring any genes, after acquiring many other genes, then when we administer this antibiotics to this bacteria do not die. Okay, this bacteria do not die. They do not die. It means this bacteria has acquired resistance against this particular antibiotic by changing in their gene. Clear? And most of the antimicrobial resistance shown by bacteria belong to this acquired category. Clear? Now, this emergence of resistance in a bacteria is a major problem today in antimicrobial therapy, because we have to first look for the antibiotics which are not resistant for this bacteria, then we can administer proper antibiotics for that bacteria. Clear? Now, coming to the intrinsic resistance. So it refers to innate ability, name itself suggesting intrinsic. So it refers to innate ability of a bacterium to resist a class of antimicrobial agents due to its inherent structural or functional characteristic. One example I will like to give here, that is gram negative bacteria are resistant to vancomycin. So this is intrinsic property of that bacteria, gram negative bacteria. They are resistant to vancomycin. Okay. So the most dangerous thing is this acquired resistance. Intrinsic resistance do not create much hindrance. Clear? So this acquired resistance is very harmful for us. Now, what are the factors which lead to acquired resistance? So the first factor is overuse and misuse of antimicrobial agents, which is the most important cause. Okay, and the evolution of resistant strain, okay, which is a natural phenomenon. Now the next one is use of a particular antibiotic poses selective pressure in a population of bacteria, which in turn promotes resistant bacteria to thrive and the susceptible bacteria to die off. Okay, so due to your antibiotic pressure also create acquired resistance. Clear? So these are the causes, and many other causes are also responsible for acquired resistance in the bacteria. Clear? Now, coming to the important point, that is your two types of drug resistance. Again, that is mutational drug resistance. Okay, and another one is your transferable drug resistance. After this, we will go for the mechanism of the drug resistance. First, we will discuss differences between mutational and transferable drug resistance. So, mutational drug resistance is due to any mutations. Okay, resistance can develop due to mutation of the resistant genes. Clear? And it is typically seen in Mycobacterium tuberculosis, which is acquiring resistance for the anti-tubercular drugs. Clear? Now, this transferable drug resistance, this resistance is due to plasmid. Okay, this resistance is plasmid coded and usually transferred by conjugation or by transduction or by transformation. Clear? Now, this is the basic. This is due to mutation, this is due to plasmid transfer. Now we will discuss differences between this. Okay, so mutational drug resistance and transferable drug resistance. So this is resistance of only one drug at a time. It is lead to multiple drug resistance. Clear? This is low degree resistance, this is high degree resistance. Okay, and this type of resistance can be overcome by combination of drugs, but this cannot be overcome by combination of drug generally. Okay, here virulence of resistance mutation may be lowered. We can lower down that virulence, but here virulence will not be lowered down. Clear? Here resistance is not transferable to another organism, but here it can be transferable because it is plasmid coded. So these are the basic differences between these two. So we have discussed now introduction, that is first we have discussed intrinsic resistance, then acquired resistance, then mutational and transferable drug resistance. Now we will come to the main topic, that is mechanism of drug resistance. Clear? So the first mechanism is your decreased permeability across the bacterial wall. Okay, so decreased permeability across cell wall. So certain bacteria modify their membrane porin channel. Okay, there will be modification on membrane porin proteins or porin channels. So bacteria modify their cell membrane porin channels either in their frequency, either in their size or selectivity. There will be modification, okay, either in its frequency, either in size and selectivity. And what is the purpose of this types of modification? Just to prevent antimicrobial agents to come inside the cell. Okay, it just prevents the entry of these antimicrobial agents into the cell. Clear? And this strategy has been observed in many gram negative bacteria, okay, such as Pseudomonas, Enterobacter, Klebsiella, okay, against the drugs such as aminoglycosides, okay, imipenem and quinolones. So one drug and one example, okay, Pseudomonas such as aminoglycosides or quinolones, you remember like this. This is the first mechanism. The second mechanism is efflux pump. Suppose antibiotics has entered inside the cell of that bacteria, but bacteria has developed efflux pump that pump out those antibiotics again. Okay, so pumping out of those antibiotics again out of the cell, okay, by the help of efflux pump. So that antibiotics will not reside inside the cell, so that cannot harm the particular cell. Clear? It is shown in E. coli, okay, E. coli against tetracyclines and chloramphenicol. Okay, writing the name chloramphenicol. So E. coli have developed resistance against tetracycline and chloramphenicol by this efflux pump development. One more example, that is Staphylococci against streptogramins. Okay, develop resistance against streptogramins. This is the second mechanism. The third mechanism is enzymatic activation, inactivation. With the help of enzymes, bacteria inactivate the drugs. Okay, so the first enzyme that bacteria produce is beta lactamase. Okay, so this enzyme production is seen in gram negative as well as gram positive both. Okay, and it breakdowns beta lactam rings. Okay, by inactivating the beta lactam antibiotics. So there are certain enzyme antibiotics which have beta lactam rings. So beta lactamase enzyme produced by bacteria which will break down these beta lactam rings. Clear? Now, the second enzyme is aminoglycoside modifying enzymes. Okay, aminoglycosides modifying enzymes such as acetyl transferases, adenyl transferases, phosphotransferases, which is produced by both gram negative and gram positive, and it destroys those antibiotics which of aminoglycosides nature. Clear? The third one is chloramphenicol acetyl transferase, also known as CAT, chloramphenicol acetyl transferase. It is produced by members of Enterobacteriaceae mainly. Okay, and it destroys the structure of chloramphenicol. Clear? This is the third mechanism. Now, coming to the fourth one, that is modifying the target sites. Okay, modifying the target site. The target site for what? Antibiotics. Antibiotics have some target site, and bacteria, what bacteria will do? Bacteria will modify that target site so that the antibiotics will not be able to identify that target site. Clear? So modification of target site of antimicrobial agent is a very important mechanism, and it is observed in first one is MRSA, that is methicillin resistant Staphylococcus aureus. Okay, in this strain, the target site of penicillin, that is known as PBP, penicillin binding protein, gets altered to PBP2A. Okay, this is original penicillin binding protein, this is original target site for penicillin, but in methicillin resistance Staphylococcus aureus, this is converted, this is altered to PBP2A. Clear? And the altered PBP coded by a chromosomally coded gene, this is coded by a gene that is known as MECA. Okay, and this will not bind to beta lactam antibiotics and therefore prevent them from inhibiting the cell wall synthesis. What actually drugs will do? Drug will bind to this PBP and inhibit cell wall synthesis. But when it is converted to PBP2A, means it is not able to bind those antibiotics and not able to stop cell wall synthesis. Clear? So this is the first example. The next one is streptomycin resistance. Streptomycin resistance is seen in Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Streptomycin resistance is seen in Mycobacterium tuberculosis. It is due to modification of ribosomal protein or 16S rRNA. So here methicillin resistance, Staphylococcus aureus, due to modification in penicillin binding protein here, 16S rRNA. So streptomycin resistance is found in Mycobacterium tuberculosis. The third one is rifampicin resistance, RR. It is seen in Mycobacterium tuberculosis as well. It is due to mutation in RNA polymerase. So this is very important MCQ question. Okay. So rifampicin resistance is due to defect in RNA polymerase enzyme, and streptomycin resistance is due to defect in 16S rRNA. Clear? Now, another examples are as well. I will give vancomycin resistance in enterococci. Vancomycin resistance enterococci. These resistance have a change in target site of vancomycin. Okay, that is D alanine. Okay, so there is change in target site of vancomycin. Vancomycin target site is D alanine. Clear? So this is about your one more example. Sorry, quinolone resistance. Okay, quinolone resistance is seen in many gram positive bacteria such as Staphylococcus aureus. Okay, Staphylococcus pneumoniae, due to mutation in DNA gyrase enzyme. So important for MCQ point of view, quinolone resistance is due to DNA gyrase mutation. Rifampicin is due to your RNA polymerase. Okay, R for rifampicin, R for RNA polymerase. So you can remember this. And streptomycin resistance is due to 16S. So SS. Clear? So this is about your mechanism for drug resistance. These are the mechanism for drug resistance. One more point I need to mention here. Beta lactamase enzymes. We will discuss here beta lactamase enzymes as well. Okay. So beta lactamase enzymes are capable of hydrolyzing the beta lactam rings of beta lactam antibiotics, thereby deactivating the antibacterial property. And they can be produced by both gram negative, gram positive. Okay. They are plasmid coated. This I will need to mention here. This is plasmid coated and transferable from one bacteria to another bacteria, mostly by conjugation. Okay, mostly by conjugation, except Staphylococcus, where they are transferred by transduction. Mostly beta lactamase enzyme resistance is plasmid coated, but and that will be by conjugation, except Staphylococcus, where plasmid coated is transferred through transduction. Clear? Now beta lactamase can be classified in two ways. That classification is important. Okay, I need to discuss here that classification. So the first classification is Umbler's classification. Okay, and this is based on structural and molecular classification. Structural and molecule. Okay, so it is also known as structural and molecular classification. Clear? According to this, the beta lactamase is classified into four class. The first one is class 1, which is known as ESBL, that is extended spectrum beta lactamase. Extended spectrum beta lactamase. Organisms which are producing ECBL enzymes are resistant to all penicillin. Okay, I will write here, resistant to all penicillin as well as first, second, third generation cephalosporins as well as monobactam. Clear? So once again, class 1, that is extended spectrum beta lactamase, they are resistant to penicillin as well as first, second and third cephalosporin as well as monobactam. Okay, they are resistant to all of these, but they are sensitive, they remain sensitive to carbapenems as well as cefamycin. Clear? They remain sensitive to carbapenem and cefamycin, but not to penicillin, cephalosporin and monobactam. Clear? Now coming to the class B, after ESBL, the class B is ampicillin beta lactamase, MC beta lactamase. Now these organisms are resistant to all antibiotics to which ECBL producers are resistant. So ECBL producers means these all antibiotics, so they are resistant to all those antibiotics to which ECBL producers are resistant, plus they are also resistant to cefamycin. Okay, so these all are same in this second, that is MC beta lactamase along with cefamycin. Okay, this is also resistant to cefamycin. Clear? But they are sensitive to carbapenems. clear? They are sensitive to carbapenems. Clear? Now coming to the class third. Okay, so class third, that includes MBL, that is metallo beta lactamase. First one was ESBL, that is extended spectrum beta lactamase. The third one MC beta lactamase, that and again MBL, that is metallo beta lactamase. These organisms are resistant to all antibiotics to which MC beta lactamase producers were there. Okay, to all. Okay, in addition, they are also resistant to carbapenems. Okay, they are also resistant to carbapenems. So along with this, carbapenem is also resistant, means it is resistant to penicillin, all generation of cephalosporins, that is first, second, third generation of cephalosporins, as well as monobactam, as well as carbapenem. Okay, as well as cephamycin, as well as carbapenems. Clear? Now coming to the fourth, that is oxacillinase. So here resistance can be overcome in this oxacillinase. Resistance can be overcome by giving your beta lactam plus beta lactamase inhibitors. In this oxacillinase, you can overcome the resistance by giving beta lactam and beta lactamase inhibitors. But in this MPC beta lactamase, okay, you cannot overcome by giving beta lactam plus beta lactamase inhibitors. Clear? This is important point. You cannot give resistance by, you cannot recover, you cannot overcome the resistance by beta lactamase inhibitor. But in oxacillinase group, you can recover by beta lactamase plus beta lactamase inhibitor combination. Clear? So this is all about your antimicrobial resistance.